Hi guys, welcome to Comfort Life Channel. I am so happy to see you here. Today I have decided to raise the question about vitamin deficiency. In our modern life, we are so overwhelmed by different dietary supplements on the market, and it's like you hear it all over the place that you are vitamin A deficient or you don't have calcium enough and so many other things. So this is an interesting question to raise, and I would like to share with you the information that I have about it, so keep watching. As you know, every day your body produces skin cells, you know, muscles and bones, all kind of things. But in order for your body to do this, it really requires some raw materials. And these materials are actually 30 essential vitamins and minerals that are considered to be nutrients. And again, they are essential because your body cannot produce them in the sufficient amount. Also, another reason for these nutrients and vitamins, minerals, basically be essential is because they help your body to convert food into energy, to repair the cellular damage, to heal the wounds, and boost your immune system, and many, many other things. So, to cut a long story short, if your body doesn't have the enough amount of these ingredients, it causes a disease. This question is interesting because many people even think, I have a proper diet, I eat enough vegetables, why am I supposed to be vitamin deficient? So vitamin deficiency in the developed countries is really widely spread, and in general, the main reasons could be alcohol, drug addiction, people take way too much prescribed drugs, and also people are having poor diet, people are smoking, people do not take care of themselves, they don't spend time outside. It's also a very important reason. And of course, elderly people in some cases, of course, have some vitamin deficiency because of the energy, protein, undernutrition. Well, as for me, let's say if I find out if I'm like vitamin A deficient, I have a question right away. What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to eat food that is rich in vitamin A, or am I supposed to just buy vitamin A in the drugstore and be happy with that? So first of all, every vitamin and mineral has a food source for it. And there's been a study proving that if you are taking dietary supplements, it doesn't protect your, you know, your body from cancer. So if you are taking dietary supplement and you are thinking that in some way it reduces the risk of cancer, you should not be thinking this way. If we're talking details here, the most important reason why some people are vitamin deficient is so obvious is the food and your diet. Because some people have poor diets, they don't eat regularly, they just don't even pay attention to what they eat. For example, if you are not eating enough greens and vegetables, it is bad because you are eating more animal products, and animal products, they are lacking like some ingredients completely, for example, magnesium, and that's not a good thing for you. Another thing you need to know here is that your body actually stores nutrients. So it means that if you are vitamin E deficient right now, it means that this deficiency actually started long time ago, and you shouldn't be thinking that last week you didn't eat something important and that's why you're lacking vitamin A right now. The second reason is very important, and it sounds really sad to me, is because this reason is our soil. You know, all the plants, they absorb these nutrients from the soil. If you want to have nutrients and vitamins in your food by eating plants, they have to be present in the soil. And in the 20th century, with the processed food and stuff, all these kind of different things towards the agriculture, many nutrients, even they have been lost. But this is a fact, that the soil is not so rich in vitamins and minerals as it used to be. The proof is very easy, is because humans historically, they have not had a significant problem of acquiring essential nutrients because they didn't have that problem back in the day. I think you also know all those cereals with added folic acid and vitamin B and some fortified cereals and all kind of things like that, and bread, because the flour that bread is made is not anymore a source of vitamin B as it used to be. So that's why they just have to add it to the product, and that's like a well-known fact. The reason number three is going to be a little more complicated. For example, your body requires vitamin D for calcium absorption, which means that without enough amounts of vitamin D, your calcium will not do a great thing for your bones and stuff. It means that if you are taking a dietary supplement like vitamin D, you have to make sure you're either taking calcium supplement or you are not deficient in calcium. Vitamin C is required for your iron absorption, but if you are having too much of vitamin C in your body, it means that your body actually is not able to absorb another essential mineral, copper. If you are taking alcohol, it means that your body is having a really hard time absorbing vitamin B1. And of course, if you're having any diseases and you are taking like prescriptional drugs, it also might like interact with the vitamin absorption. So if you know that you are deficient on this that vitamin, you of course first of all have to see if you have any underlying condition, because that might be a reason. And maybe I could give you another advice is, you cannot really just think that you are deficient in vitamin A or vitamin B. Yes, there are some symptoms, but for sure you could find out only by having a blood test. And it means that you need to talk to your doctor about this, and of course you need to talk to your doctor before starting taking any dietary supplement. So basically these are the main reasons why people, even with a proper diet, are still lacking some of the vitamins. And the reason I'm advising you to not just to go to the store and buy a dietary supplement is because all vitamins and minerals, they're supposed to stay in balance. This is a very tiny balance thing, because too much of the vitamins might be very bad, and a little bit less of the vitamins might still cause a disease. And it's probably hard to perform this balance, but I think a good advice is not to overdo anyway, because moderation is the key. It is a very rare chance to get too much of the vitamins just from the food source. So that's why I'm actually bringing dietary supplements here for you, so you could be aware about the dosage, because when you go to the store, vitamin A could be in different milligrams. You need to know which exactly milligram dose you need. And maybe another thing will convince you is that doctors and nutritionists, they are still 100% sure that the healthiest and the best way for you to absorb and get all the vitamins and minerals is through a healthy diet and by spending a decent amount outdoors, at least spending half hour outdoors every day, preferably when the sun is still up, or even if it's not the sunny weather, before the evening time. If you are unable to perform a healthy lifestyle, exercising, good diet, you know, spending time outdoors, of course dietary supplements should be a way out for you, but make sure you talk to your doctor before taking any steps. I hope you find this video helpful and informative, and for me the purpose of this video was actually to convince you to start eating healthy, to start thinking good things, and to start spending at least a little bit of time out of doors. And another purpose was just to make you think that dietary supplements are not a miracle thing over there that you take and then you start becoming really healthier and all kind of things. Yes, most of the things do help, but please be reasonable and please be smart. A healthy body fat with a healthy food is able to produce its own vitamins, except for the vitamin C. Healthy food is not something plastic, it's not something puffed up, refined, stabilized, chemicalized. It's not fruits picked up green. It's not healthy food is not bleached or sprayed as in grains and cereals. And a healthy diet is the only thing that will help you to actually recover your intestinal tract, because this is something that gets really damaged by antibiotics, by prescription drugs, by preservatives, and unhealthy food. The unhealthy food blocks your flora to manufacture the essential vitamins and minerals, and in some cases completely. So that's why a healthy diet is something you must start with. Thank you so much for watching this video. Put the thumbs up if you like it, subscribe to my channel, and I wish you all the best. In the next videos, I'm going to talk to you about each vitamin and why it is important for you, which food sources you can get it from, and what are the general symptoms of this or that vitamin deficiency.